Voting in the US midterm elections has closed. Republicans are poised to regain control of the House of Reps, but the future of the Senate is still up in the air, and it's also still unclear whether Donald Trump will attempt a comeback. And Steve Clemons is here to give us his take on the latest results. Steve, how are you seeing the results so far?
Well, I think the big takeaway for today's elections is there was no red wave. And we were all kind of expecting, given polls and whatnot, to see a landslide for Republicans in the House of Representatives and potentially in the United States Senate. But as things look right now, the Republicans are going to get the House of Representatives, but maybe with only one or two seat margin. And I have to say, that's going to make the leader of the Republican Party just, you know, have nightmares every night on how to hold them together. And in the Senate right now, it's looking very possible that the Democrats not only keep the Senate and keep control, but actually add a seat, because right now they just were announced that they won Pennsylvania, which was a very hotly contested race. So it's very, very different. And we have lots of diverse candidates that have come in, including the first two lesbian governors in both Oregon and in Massachusetts that have come into players, and lots of diversity throughout. So it's a very unexpected outcome, but that's what democracy is supposed to be about.
Unexpected outcomes. And America's seen a few of them lately. But just going back to the House and the Senate, as you describe it, if it falls that way, what does that mean for the rest of President Joe Biden's term?
Well, I think with the Republicans getting control of the House of Representatives, they're still going to try their best to cause him pain and to disrupt the Biden agenda. But it's really, really hard when you only have one or two seats, because in that large a caucus, you can have people that fall a different direction. It's also going to create problems of managing that, because people like Marjorie Taylor Greene, who's famous for she wasn't given a seat assignment. She's looked at as someone who affiliates with white supremacists and says some pretty, out of the baseball field things now and then, that she is going to have more power within the Republican caucus, but that's going to make it harder for them to control and have their own agenda. So that's one dimension. Biden is going to have a tough time with his agenda, but so will the Republicans. And in the Senate, I think controlling the Senate is going to allow Biden to continue to get confirmations through that are very key. So it's not as bleak a picture for Democrats as I think they were bracing for yesterday.
Right. Good to check in tonight, Steve. Thanks so much for your time.
My pleasure.